Did you hear about the girl that went fishing with seven guys?
No.
She came back with a red snap.
Ooh.
I don't get it, but that's okay.
I'll tell you what, let's bring the pizza. Want to stop with a little spinach?
Tell you what, let's bring the pizzas up here. I think it's a great idea. And then we can start working on
it. Yes. So the pizzas are always in the shot. The food on a food program should always be front and center.
Would you look at that thing that's blue?
And you see, it's not a perfect round pizza. It's a traditionally Neapolitan pizzas, but slightly in the shape.
It's one for each of you. Or Kevin might eat both of them. I don't know.
All right, we're going to go rock it out now with a little red snapper.
This is one of the most exciting programs I've ever done. Look at this.
Say we do a little score on the fish.
You score on that.
Like this.
Explain just why you're scoring.
Two reasons. One, it's going to look real pretty, and two, it's going to cook evenly.
And also what? It'll absorb the olive oil
exactly.
And the herbs? That's
soak,
what I like about it.
It's going to soak in the flavor.
I think it's a great idea.
Now, what we could do, a little olive oil. Rub it in nice like that. Make sure you get it right in there.
Nice.
You got a little salt and pepper, Nick?
Yeah, I got everything for you.
I've never been this close to a fish in my life. Yeah. Thank you, Matthew.
You need some garlic, right? Oh, absolutely. You want to open the stomach for
me, right? We're going to go right in the hole.
A little bit.
Stick it in the hole, sweetie. Come on. There we go.
All right. Open up that stomach for me.
Come on.
On the side. What I like to do is I like to slice some lemon really thin. See, if I'm slicing the lemon really thin, I can put it in the stomach, and it permeates the flavor of the citrus into the fish, and it kind of wakes it up without overpowering.
You can even really get
Have
crazy.
Have you been on TV before, man?
You know what? You want to stick a little spinach in the belly, too?
I think it's a great idea.
Why not?
That garlic and everything sauteed. Now, that spinach has been pre-sauteed a little bit. Not too much. There you go. That's perfect. And then you have...
We got any fresh herb?
A touch of oregano. That's the Sicilian oregano. And fresh herbs with fish in southern Italy, we like to use parsley. An Italian flat leaf parsley has been freshly chopped. We douse it with olive oil, so that way it actually creates a
You know
a
what?
Sear.
You want to get really crazy?
What do you think?
What about a little peppers and capers in there?
Now you go all the way out.
Oh, boy.
We're going to stick some of that in there. We're going to stick some
boy.
Of that in there.
That's going to roast amazing in there. Slowly.
Absolutely.
So we're going to put it in a chafing dish with some extra virgin olive oil. So the fish does not stick.
Minky, look at that.
Look at me.
Look at who's better than us?
Who's better than us?
No. Nobody. Nobody.
We got meatballs.
A tavola.
We got a glass of wine. Who's better than us?
All right. And now they're going to cook the fish in real time.
You know what? You want to do a little roast with portobello too?
I think it's a great idea.
Can we have one of those mushrooms? Why not? We're putting the camera guy to work too. You want to
yeah, he's
there?
Italian. He's used to this.
Watch this. We take that right out.
So what are you doing? You're slicing it first?
I think we keep it whole.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
not in a bias? So you have, like,
you want to do something
faster?
Like this?
So, hey, go a little
Let's
faster.
Do this. Watch this.
Yeah, you want to show some fancy knife work.
Of course,
folks at home want to see what you're doing.
Olive oil, beautiful. Meat.
And do try this at home, ladies and gentlemen. Yes.
Extra virgin olive oil, only the best. You know what? We got
What are you doing now?
We got any rosemary or some...
I don't have rosemary on hand.
Salt and pepper.
I have salt and pepper.
Maybe a little balsamic.
A little parsley, maybe. There you go. Now, what did you put on there?
We got a little bit of the juice
like
and the oil.
The juice of the roasted pepper.
From the roasted pepper, which
has a little bit of vinegar in it.
Absolutely. And we need a little bit of acid.
Yeah, that's what makes you.
To kick it up. You know what?
You'll take that extra step to do something that's so out of the ordinary, you know.
We're going to put a little olive on here, too, just to even kick it up.
The roasted olive.
Cool. Roasted olive is an absolutely beautiful thing.
I hear that looks great. Okay.
Now keep in mind, the one thing about mushrooms, like eggplant, they suck up a lot of oil. So don't be afraid to.
Oh, boy.
What's wrong with a little extra virgin olive oil?
Yeah.
And that is amazing.
Now, while that's cooking.
Yes, applause.
Let's have another sip of wine.
Let's take it.
We could do some artichoke, too. Most people are afraid of artichoke.
They are. Should we show them how you clean them?
Yeah, you know what? Let's do it.
They don't know what to do with an artichoke.
It was funny that you say that because I actually put it on special in my uncle's restaurant in Virginia, and somebody ordered it, and they called me out. They said, this looks delicious, but we don't know how to eat it. Unless you've had it when you were a kid, you really don't know it. And looking at it, it's a little scary, isn't it? I mean, I'd be scared of this thing.
And you know what?
I've always had mixed feelings about artichokes.
It's really not a vegetable. It's a flower. And it's actually the thistle of a flower.
That's absolutely correct.
And that's exactly what it is. It's very good. It is believable.
You said that again. Was it thistle?
It's a thistle.
A thistle?
I like
it's
that
a
word.
Thistle. No, it's a thistle. And in Italy, it's believed to be a healing properties for your liver. It's a liver cleanser. But Italians really eat it because they love it. And they eat it all the time.
We used to do a little stuffed artichoke with the breadcrumb, like the oregano mix. Wow. My mom used to make it. My father used to make it with the cheese and the oregano.
How are we doing back in there with the fish?
We're experiencing technical difficulties right now, literally.
All right, the oven is melting. Now, wait a minute.
So now we're seeing the fish.
Oh, oh my God.
A little bit, that's a
Oh, I want to eat that so bad right now, but it's not finished yet.
No, turn it, turn it, so that way the back of the oven is hotter. Let's see what they're doing now, hold on. Those mushrooms, you know, they cook fast.
They cook fast. Yeah, mushrooms cook fast.
Oh, wow.
Oh. All right.
You can see them searing in that olive oil, fresh herbs.
Can you smell that? It's in there. Beautiful.
And what I'll do is to give it a nice crunch, I'm going to raise it to the roof of the oven.
Oh, my God.
The roof of the oven is actually hot.
Now, you do this for all the customers who come in here?
Oh, you want? Now you bring some charcoal oil in there?
Yeah, come on, wait
on. Now, see, by raising it to the roof, we're getting a much hotter sear on the vegetable, creating that caramelization on the vegetable.